إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, couple of weeks back I went to eat with my ahl in a lawful restaurant, inshallah, halal restaurant, but owned by non-Muslims. I was amazed when the person who was serving the food approached me and he asked where I come from and why I'm dressed like this. And he told me, my grandfather used to dress like you exactly, used to look like you exactly. I asked him, what is your name? He said, Eric. Then I asked him, what is your grandfather's name? He said, Medina. Where he comes from? From Spain. But he is from Mexico. You probably can connect the dots now. We used to have Islam in Spain. And then when Islam went down, all these Muslims had to leave. And his grandfather, the Muslim grandfather, migrated to Mexico. And his offspring is Eric. Eric is a Catholic. Alhamdulillah, I invited him to the masjid and I shared with him the Quran. Take it easy. I would like to see you again. Allah knows best. We make dua for Eric that Allah guides him back to Islam. When the Muslim world went down, Khilafah, yani. In our homelands, we had issues. Unable to make a living. Actually, Muslims were oppressed there. People who, like for example, in Egypt, during the reign of Mubarak, every time I fly back to Egypt, I would have to stop at the airport for at least 2 hours to be interrogated. Because of the fact that I travel like this, I look like a Muslim, and this is a Muslim country. A lot of us left seeking the dunya, seeking freedom, whatever it is. And when we come here and we begin living, then we find out that there is a ruling actually regarding staying in this land. A lot of Muslims don't know this, but after they migrate, يعرف يعني المسلم يهاجر إلى بلاد غير المسلمين وبعدين إيه يعرف إذن أن هناك حكم شرعي لإقامة المسلم بين غير المسلمين. يعني he leaves his homeland not knowing anything. He does not know he's caring for earning the bread, having a better life, or finding more freedom. And then once he comes here, then he hears that text. يعني hear that stuff. أنا بريء ممن يقيم بين ظهراني المشركين. يعني الحديث في سنن أبي داود من صححه ومن ضعفه. But there is other hadith. The Prophet says, I disclaim a person who lives amongst the mushriks. نار المؤمن ونار المشرك لا تتراءى. The cooking fire, or the fire which you use to cook as a Muslim, should not be seen by a mushrik. يعني المعنى ان الفصل totally. ولا يجامع المشرك إلا مثله. Someone who associates with a mushrik is someone like him. والآية العمدة, the verse in this regard, فيما كنتم قالوا كنا مستضعفين في الأرض قالوا ألم تكن أرض الله واسعة فتهاجروا فيه. يعني في حكم شرعي, في كلام في الموضوع. I'm not going to address it here, but I'm telling you, those who said that it is permissible for you to stay here, they tied it to a condition. There must be a condition that you fulfill. And by the way, I have no intention to disregard my brothers and sisters who are born here and they reverted to Islam. I also find a lot of them asking and calling, Sheikh, should I go to a Muslim land? They actually have that urge too, because they see the text. And again, I'm not addressing al-hukm al-shar'i. يعني I'm not, don't mistake me. Ahlul ilm, the people of knowledge who are much better than me, addressed it. Review it, it's available. But I want to take the view which is the view of the majority of them, that if you decide to live here, here yani in a land where the majority of people are not Muslims, conditions must be fulfilled. It's not an open invitation. Why? I will mention why after sharing with you the consequences of living in such an environment without basically establishing these conditions. يعني the condition is you must establish the religion where you are. You must be secure in your deen. You must be able to show that you're a Muslim. And I will go back to this and how to do it. But first, the impact, number one, ilful aada. بفضل الله, every morning after Fajr, we explain to the brother Surah Al-Baqarah. And we were talking about the children of Israel. They were in Egypt for years. And then Prophet Musa alayhi salam came and took them out of bondage. أخرجهم من مصر يعني. And here they saw with their eyes Allah saving them. يعني when they arrived at the Red Sea water, The Pharaoh and his army are behind them. فلما تراءى الجمعان قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون. He said, كلا إن معي ربي سيهدين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands Prophet Musa alayhi salam to cast the sea with his stick, staff. It turned into a bridge. This is a physical, miraculous sign that they saw with their own eyes. But look, وَجَاوَزْنَا بِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْبَحْرِ. And as soon as the children of Israel passed, فَأَتَوْا عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ يَعْكُفُونَ عَلَىٰ أَصْنَامٍ لَهُمْ. They saw some Bedouins in the desert worshipping an idol in Sinai. What did they say? قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى اجْعَلْ لَنَا إِلَهًا كَمَا لَهُمْ آلِهًا. Musa, can we please have an idol like this? I'm asking you why. Because they lived in that environment all their lives. Look at the Egyptian history. Look at the Egyptian monuments, all rocks, stones. Wherever they go, actually they used to make these stones for them, idols. So they are accustomed. They are accustomed to see it. Ilful al-'ada. When you live in such environment, you get used to it. You do not move. It does. You do not move. You do not condemn it in your heart. Ya ikhwa, I'll never forget when I was in Maryland. It happens in my way that there was a Catholic church, and they had an idol of Maryam. Yani for them, yani. We know that they worship her. So the first day I'm passing by and I saw this Catholic going in front of the idol and bowing down. You cannot imagine my heart bumping. It's the first time I see this. Guess what? The following day, it dies. Because you get used to it. إِلْفُ الْعَادِ فَاجْتَنِبُ الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ. That is why Allah tells you, avoid any icon of shirk, any act of shirk. Don't be an environment of shirk. And that is why the ruling about attending funerals of non-Muslims. Without going into details, I'm not passing a ruling here, but إِلْفُ الْعَادِ. Don't you hear your son sometimes when he gets upset, your son who goes to a public school, says, Jeez? Yes, some of our children say this, Jesus, when he gets angry, or when he gets upset. Why? He's used to it. Not necessarily he believes in it, but he is used to it. So when you live in a place where shirk is committed, you don't deny it anymore. You don't condemn it in your heart anymore. Add to this, شائرة الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر تتوقف. Enjoining good and forbidding evil dies. You cannot do it. Like as a Muslim, if you pass by and you see a man and woman committing adultery in the street, what are you going to do? It dies. But in my humble opinion, the most devastating consequences is losing the next generation. And this is exactly what happened to Eric. And happened to a lot of Muslim children. Their parents came here. They were not aware of the condition for them to be here, to continue being here. They neglected that condition. As a result of this, they lost themselves and they lost their children. One of the parents in this community came came to me, when are you going to have the school? My child is teaching me now that Jesus is the Son of God. But for you to stay here in this land, you must establish the religion. You must establish the deen. You must have institutions which protect your identity as a Muslim and protect the identity of your children. No question about it. Brothers and sisters in Islam, في سورة النساء, a situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrates it to us, which is at the time of death. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ ظَالِمِي أَنفُسِهِمْ. Indeed, those whom the angels will come to take their souls while they are in a state of transgression, they are disobedient. Angels came to take their souls, they found them disobedient to Allah. The angels, those are the angels who arrived before the angel of death, they would then ask that person, فِيمَ كُنْتُمْ. What led you to this? How dare you neglect your religion that you die in this condition? Ya ikhwa, our religion teaches us, Allah teaches us in the Quran and the Sunnah, in the tongue of His Messenger, that the most important thing in your lives is the deen, the religion. To the extent that He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that at the time of trials and tribulations, a believer will pass by the graveyard of another believer, the grave, the tomb of another Muslim, and he will wish to be in his place. يَمُرُّ الرَّجُلُ بِقَبْرُ الرَّجُلُ فَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي مَكَانَكَ. I wish I am in your place. Why? Because he's going through fitna. He's afraid he's going to lose his deen. He's afraid he's going to lose Islam. That is why he wanted the process to finish. So he is done. Dying as a Muslim is a success. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Don't you dare die but as Muslims. Don't allow yourselves to die but as Muslims. That is why in the bed of death, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to prompt, to ask those who are about to die to say the kalima. Say la ilaha illallah. Pronounce it. So you're a Muslim. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the angels will question them. Why? You know what they say to them? We were oppressed. We were outnumbered. That's another meaning. Kunna mustad'afina fil ard. We were minority in Colorado. Will that excuse be accepted? No. Alam takun ardullahi wasi'atan fatuhajiru fiha. Why didn't you leave? Why didn't you stay in this place where you could not guard your religion? You must have another agenda. You had a good job, and that job came at the expense of your deen. The deen was secondary in your life. The religion was in the side, washy-washy. But the dunya is the agenda. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. The abode of those will be the hellfire. وَالْعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. For my message today to my brothers and sisters in Islam, we as a community must establish the deen, the religion in Colorado. I arrived here 2.5 years back. Almost, more or less. Something that I saw with my own eyes. We do not have the next generation. We don't. As a community in Colorado, we don't. We neglected them. We given them a version of Islam. And don't think that I'm trying to get some, you know, fanatics here. La ya akhi. The basics, wallahi. The basics. I'm asking for the basics for that generation. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this has to change. Otherwise, your child, not necessarily your child, but your grandchild could become another Eric. If you do not pass on that commitment to your own child. You see, it's a chain reaction. Eric is a third generation. Eric is a third generation, is not the first generation. So you may be doing washy-washy job with your own child. Guess what? Your child will do only a washy job with his child. And then his child will do no job with his child. Then your offspring are Eric's. It doesn't have to come right away. No. It's a chain reaction. We have to do something, brothers and sisters in Islam, for our ummah here in Colorado. And our focus must be around the next generation. Providing for them the environment, the masjid, and the school. You probably have been hearing me critiquing Crescent View all the time about the fact that the teachers are not hijabi. There is no segregation between the boys and girls. And you know what? If you look at it, it costs a lot of money to run an institution like this. And they don't have full control of Crescent View because they have to take a program, a government or whatever it is program, so that they are funded. But is that the solution? No. But for the brothers in Crescent View to make a decision, to turn things around, we must show them something. Also, when I ask a brother and a sister, especially brothers who do not come to the masjid regularly, oh, we live far away, we're not here. Brothers and sisters in Islam, since that idea of general body meetings came up in the ummah, where basically the masjid invites the community members to come and see what has been happening and so forth. All what I see is people who are coming to say, you did not do this, you did not do that, you did not do this, you did not do this. Just few brothers, maybe handful, 5, 10, they just come and turn the whole scene into a turmoil. And when I ask a brother, who I see him in the masjid all the time, Akhi, why don't you come to this function? Sheikh, I don't like politics. What politics? What politics? This is the future of your ummah. This is the future of your children. This general body meeting coming up on Sunday at 10 o'clock in the morning is amana. And I'm not passing a ruling again. If you have an excuse, don't come. But I'm telling you, you must come as a good brother and find out what is happening in this community. What is being done for your children? What is being done for the future of Colorado? And after my short break, inshallah, I will break a piece of the news that will be surprising for you on Sunday, inshallah, which will help our brothers in Crescent View Academy first, and Al Ihsan Academy also, and will help the community at large. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. يا إخوة، الرائد لا يكذب أهله. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed you in charge, you have something to say, you have to be honest. You have to state the truth to the community and to the people who are in charge. And that is my job. By no means, and Allah is my witness, that I use this minbar to settle any personal things. La wallahi. Allah is my witness. Nothing. But I know when I pass on that sirat, you know, when the day of resurrection is over, at the end of the day, the last of the scenes of the day of resurrection is a bridge on the top of the hellfire, thinner than a piece of hair, sharper than the edge of a sword. You're going to have to walk on it. Beneath you, the hellfire. Around the sirat, تبعث الأمانة والرحم. الأمانة will be there. If Allah entrusted you with something, entrusted you with a position, entrusted you of the ummah, and you betrayed this entrust, that amana hook will grab you into the hellfire. Khiyana. Khiyana. This is the premise, and Allah is my witness. For the first time since I came to Colorado again, 2.5 years back, we had a meeting with the community leaders across Colorado. All the way, actually, Colorado Springs, the brothers came. And we presented to them the idea of a community center. Masjid, schools, but first of all, how to sustain these institutions. Meaning housing, meaning businesses. This is how you're going to support these institutions. And I'm sorry, our brothers in Crescent View Academy, they have a point. Their budget is $1 million and now almost 200. Who's going to support this? Now, if we establish this, we can support our institutions, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. We're not going to come every now and then and nag about a fundraising, about a fundraising, about a fundraising. You remember 3 years back, actually 2.5, otherwise I'll be lying here, 2.5 years back, the first Ramadan, when I saw the problem we have with the parking lot, I said, brothers, in Ramadan, that first Ramadan, I said, brothers, we need to raise funds to buy a piece of land here and there in order to solve that problem. We raised almost, actually, in the bank account as we speak right now, $145,000. This money is untouched, and it will stay like this until the donors, Hadi al-Sharia, decide what to do with it. Yes, I remember me and my brothers, we invited the person, the prospective neighbor, who's thinking about selling his place, so we can solve the problem of the parking, he asked for $760,000. Is that a solution? The other solution to have a parking lot is to build a multi-levels building. This is going to cost at least $2 million. These are halfway solutions. Now, on Sunday, I'm inviting all of the brothers of this community, and please mark your calendar, 10 o'clock in the morning, the general body meeting, and the item there is the presentation of that community center. We want to hear from you. We want to transfer this money with the permission of the donors into that account. And we need to campaign throughout Colorado to raise a decent amount of money in order to purchase the land to begin with. This project is probably 30, 40, some people say 50, some people say $20 million, but it can be phased out. Buying a piece of land big enough to build on it, and we phase it. What do we need right now as a community? We need a school. But before we think about the school, we need to support the school. We need to support the school. Can we do some businesses around it? Can we sell some of this land to be housing? I know engineers will have their say about this, technicalities. I'm not an engineer, but that is why we need you on Sunday, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, to come. This is the future of your ummah. This is the future of Colorado. Colorado Muslim Society is the largest community here in Denver. And inshallah, we're going to make this a community at large project. Masjid al-Nur is part of it. Crescent View Academy is part of it. But we have to take the lead. But work with our brothers to possibly make this happen. Inshallah, my goal by the end of this year, or maybe like this time next year, we have the land done. Then we can start thinking about developing phases, until we build our community, our ummah here in Colorado. That's my message for today, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. I tried hard to make it as friendly as possible, so you don't get scared and come on Sunday, inshallah. Our brothers in Crescent View Academy, they have their fundraising next Saturday. Mark your calendar. They are selling tickets outside. Help them out. Help them out. Let's think as a community. By the way, I had meetings with them lately, and alhamdulillah, there is a great deal of understanding. And I think all of us as a community will work towards better the condition of the ummah here in Colorado. Say, inshallah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم استعملنا ولا تستبدلنا. اللهم استعملنا ولا تستبدلنا. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وأعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم انصر دينك. اللهم انصر دينك. اللهم انصر إخواننا في جميع بلاد المسلمين على من عاداهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم زكي أنفسنا وزكي أنفس أولادنا وبناتنا يا رب العالمين، واحفظهم بحفظك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم اجعلنا من هؤلاء الذين ينبتون نبتا حسنا في هذا البلد يدعو إلى الله، نبتا لا يصبح كافرا ولا مشركا يا رب العالمين. اللهم استعملنا في هذه يا ربي. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، وأقم الصلاة.
Hmm.